welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Temple is lined up for the opening kickoff, so here we go. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 24. So the Aggies offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing about, I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
Second down and 17 to go. Ball on the 17-yard line. He goes out of bounds, right around the 20. Steps out of bounds at the 33.
That makes us 4th and inches.
He makes it to the 35-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Quick strike to the back, no good.
Boy, he put so much heat on that ball, I don't think anybody wanted to get their hands on that.
That makes it 2nd and 10.
It's 2nd and 10. Ball on their own 35. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He gets hit out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
From the 45-yard line, first down. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
From the 26-yard line, 2nd down. Great concentration to pull it in. And down he goes at the 16-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
This comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver. And the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Run there. A 4-yard gain by the halfback on the option.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
From the 12-yard line, it's 2nd down.
He is is such a talented, skillful back, as you saw right there. What makes him even better is that these coaches know how to use him.
And he adds the extra point. It was a 7-play, 65-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
It's fielded at the 2. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. The Owls are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He's to the 40. He's tackled at the 40.
Man, the defense looked a little sluggish there. They can do better than that.
There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He's out of bounds. Down the 43-yard line.
That's some pretty timid play calling right there. Let's see if they decide to open it up a bit more.
5 wide. Carries the ball for a nice game. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a 5-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. Tackle made at about the 41. So the quarterback keeps it on the option, but he'll lose a yard. Stop right around the 34.
Hey, it's a first down for this offense that keeps everybody enthusiastic. You can see the momentum that this offense is gaining. The coaches and the players on the sideline are fired up, and hey, it's a new set of downs.
Zips it to the back. Back to the line, maybe a yard on the pass.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
The 25-yard line.
Here we go, keep them on the field. Mike 35. Here we go. Red 18.
Out of bounds at about the 23-yard line.
The defense is there to defend the pass, but we're still unable to stop them from picking up enough yards to move the chain.
Strike, and he drops it. So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 23. He's on the run. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Aggies.
Put his eyes on that end zone and ran with some real purpose there.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He makes the PAT. It was an 11-play, 74-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 3. He's to the 20. And And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
Zips it left. And it's intercepted. Tackle around the 41-yard line. He just jumped up and snatched that ball.
Well, there, I don't think the quarterback even saw him. The defender went up into the air and made a great catch.
We talked about this sophomore before the game, and he sure can play, I'll tell you that. From the 41-yard line, first down. He heaves it deep. Can't connect. So at the end of one quarter, we get a tie game at 7-7. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we've got a tight ball game. There's a strike complete. Knocked out of bounds around the 37-yard line. Scrambling, diving for extra yardage, and he tucked that one in for about 5 yards. He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. Here's the punt. No, they're gonna throw it. No good on fourth down. Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. They try running left. Runs outside for a nice gain. From their own 37-yard line, it's second down. Down at the 34. Quick pass. And he hits him hard at the 39-yard line. Certainly, they don't have the return on here. Fielded at the 19. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Gets it. He's in space. And he's tackled at the 35-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
Has some daylight. They bring him down around the 46-yard line. Receiver in a hurry, and he's taken down the 42-yard line. guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. To about the 37-yard line. From the 37-yard line, third down. Got a man, watch out here. He steps out the 33-yard line. Down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
Gets it out quickly to the back, but he can't haul it in. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 19. He's hit hard. He's scrambling. And he's leveled at the 7-yard line. So he got enough for the first down there.
Yep, nice call to run the ball there on third down. I like it.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Touchdown. And he converts the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 18. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. From their own 32-yard line. It's first down.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
That makes it second and 10.
He gets rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He wants it all going long. Found his man. He's all the way. Touchdown.
White out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
That's a great touchdown, Brad, but what happened to the coverage there by the defense? The defensive coordinator's got to be beside himself. You know, you work all week long on studying the offense and their tendencies, and then to have a mental error and to leave the star receiver open like that for a touchdown, well, they've got to regroup.
And he tacks on the extra point. Temple yet set to kick this one away. He'll take it from the 2. He's tackled at the 30-yard line. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. He's going to try and scramble. And he is drilled at the 33. Scrambling around. Picks up five on the scramble. He scrambled. Slides down. Tries to buy some time. And he tackles him hard at the 48-yard line.
Good coverage by the defense, but they have to be aware of this quarterback's tendency to scramble around and pick up some yards.
Quick throw. And down he goes at about the 35. We've played a half. 14 apiece.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. The pass rush of both teams has been totally negated in the first half. Neither team has been able to come up with a sack. So what's the D-line coach right now preaching to you guys up front, you big fellas who love to go there and make life miserable for a quarterback?
Well, you got to watch the football and get off it as soon as you can and try to get that first step quickness, because I know those guys are big and strong, but they're also a little bit chunky. And if you're on the defensive line and you're a little bit slimmer and you get off the football a little bit faster, but try to get off that ball quick. And it's not just sacks where you see. How about you affect the quarterback? How about you bull rush your guy and you put him in his lap and you make him throw over top, or, you know, change the throwing angle so he doesn't have a clean pocket where he can step up in there and make big throws the whole game. You got to do something different than you did the first half to affect the quarterback.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
Great first half and a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. So they get 5 yards there on the halfback draw. That's a D-line play. That makes it 7-6. From their own 25-yard line, second down. Get to that quickly. He's tackled around the 30-yard line. It to the 32-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 32. Nice run up the middle.
Gaining 5 on the play. That brings him second and 5.
Right here.
He tackles him for a loss, and the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
Third down again. And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. the 38-yard line. And he was able to pick up some nice yards on the return. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Quick pass, and he's right there to knock it away.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
From their own 38-yard line, second down. Toss across the middle. Tackle made around the 49-yard line. He goes out of bounds. Right around the 46-yard line. Pulls it in, and that's a first down. And they make the stop at the 32-yard line. Makes it out to about the 23. Rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. He's taken down around the 12-yard line.
Once you get inside the 10-yard line, this halfback is automatic.
And he adds the extra point. So the Aggies running back sidelined earlier with that injury. Right now, though, it looks like he's warming up and trying to get back in the ballgame.
Texas A&M is ready to kick it away. It's fielded at the 2. Brought down at the 26-yard line.
Texas A&M's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this, and another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Heading for the corner. Tackle at the 35. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Makes it out to about the 49.
Jones at the 40. And they push him out
at about the 33-yard line.
First and 10. Ball on the 33. Carries the ball for a nice gain.
Makes the tackle. Gain of seven on the play. That makes it second and two.
Got some open field.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 14-yard line. Tries to get around the corner. He's pushed out of bounds.
At about the 5-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
Three-yard line.
And that's it for quarter number three. Folks, we got a great game on our hands. 21-14, Aggie. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Quick pass. Touchdown, Owls. That was a big, big score, and it makes it a one-possession game, but we've still got a lot of football left. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. So they're going to try and determine exactly where the ball was when he went down. So the booth is trying to determine exactly where they'll spot the ball.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So they'll respot the ball, and we'll get this game going again. And the goal line defense digging in here. Touchdown, Temple!
Really good vision here by the quarterback and a good understanding of where he was on the field. He didn't need much, and he knew he could get it himself.
The extra point to tie this game up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Yeah, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Now he's flushed and they got it. Aggressive call there to send the corner and it paid off.
Boy, did he get in there quick or what?
From their own 20-yard line. It's second down. They'll bring him down right around the 20. He's looking for his man. This one will fall incomplete.
Number 25 breaks it up. Fourth down.
it out to about the 47-yard line. You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. And he's tackled at about the 39-yard line. From the 39-yard line, first down. They'll go with the run once again. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That makes it second and six.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. And he's taken down around the 33-yard line.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
Just under three to go in regulation. It's up. And it's good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Texas A&M's been unable to really show that they're the team to beat here, but it looks like they're going to get another chance at it.
Well, it's now or never. This team has put themselves in a position where they have to hope for some heroics late. It's because they played sloppy most of the game. They're very fortunate they still have a chance to be able to win this game.
Throws left, the running back's got it. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run. And a 6-yard pickup by the halfback on the delay. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. Throws and it's knocked away. Just over 2 minutes in the game. Screen here, and the halfback's got it. And they got him for a loss.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. It off. Gets out to around the 38. Good execution on the counter, and that'll be a 10-yard gain. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Nice run there.
Now, the defense knew that this offense was trying to work the clock. When you want to work the clock, you're going to run the football. Puts a lot of pressure on the offensive line to get low and drive that defensive line back. And that's what they were able to do there to give the running back enough room to pick up that first down. It's never good for a back's confidence to get tackled for a loss. But this guy knows that he's got to just keep at it, and the holes will start to open up.
They hand it off. And down he goes at the 37.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 21. Down. They're going to try a long field goal here. A little over a minute in the game. Kicks away, and he nails the long field goal. Temple kicked this one off. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So the Aggies have got to be just a little bit careful that they lean too much on a star player here in this stage of the game.
Yeah, but having a quarterback that understands what this defense wants to try to do to slow this offense down is very, very important. Now he's just got to stay calm, make good decisions, and move his offense down the field.
He's tackled in the open field. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
Watch the run, watch the run.
Makes the grab, and he's got the first. He's tackled around the 39-yard line.
98 Weasel! 98 Weasel!
From their own 39-yard line. It's second down.
Mike 35, Mike 35.
He chucks it downfield. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened.
Check, check. 98 Weasel! 98 Weasel! Let's go,
hurry. Spikes the ball.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 14. Intercepted. The offense took an errant shot into the end zone, and I'll tell you what, that one should have been picked off.
Yeah, I'm sure he's going to hear all about that from his teammates when he comes over to the sidelines.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. It's caught, and we are all tied up, folks. Texas A&M's back in the football game, tied up now thanks to their star quarterback.
Now, one thing about this quarterback, he just led them to a huge drive here late in the game, and you know, he just wants his hands on the football one more time before we head to overtime.
They'll try to tack on the extra point that will take the lead. He makes the PAT. And with time winding down, they probably won't let this return man feel the ball. He'll return it from the one. Tackle at the 26. Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game. And poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? from their own 26-yard line. Second down. The cavalry's coming. Tackle made right around the 40.
This is a pretty tough guy, and he's a great leader. He's going to do whatever it takes to help his team.
One last play, folks. It's time to find out how far he can throw it and see if this game becomes one of the all-time greatest. Here we go. Texas A&M staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.